Hi, I'm Celeste Siam.
Hi, I'm Mark Lawrence.
Hi, I'm Pete Tong.
Hi guys, it's Steve Angello.
Hi, I'm Jeremy Boone from Zouk Singapore.
Hey, what's up? I'm Mim.
I'm Liv.
We're NERVO. We're here in Singapore for IMS.
Hi, this is Damian Lazarus, and I'm here at the IMS Asia Pacific, and you are watching DJsounds.com.
DJsounds have landed in Singapore, a vibrant, colourful and a super dynamic city, as well as being the international hub of Asia. It's for these very reasons that the International Music Summit founders, Pete Tong, Danny Whittle, Mark Neto, Simeon Friend and Ben Turner, chose this dynamic and forward-thinking city to host the very first IMS Asia Pacific. The International Music Summit was born in Ibiza 7 years ago. She has since taken up residency in LA with IMS Engage and now has launched upon yet another continent, bringing for the first time ever, a conference of its kind to Asia. This one-day event is full of panel discussions, keynote presentations, one-on-one interviews, and technology displays from Pioneer DJ, who are also celebrating their 20th anniversary in style right here at the W Hotel. There are pre and post IMS parties at Attica Nightclub, and of course the IMS team have timed it perfectly, teaming up with Zouk Out, the biggest outdoor festival of its kind in Asia. Danny Whittle, why Singapore?
You know, we looked at other places. I mean, we initially thought of Australia, but then we just thought it would be too Australian-centric. We looked at Hong Kong, and we just thought it was kind of too much, too busy. We just thought Singapore just looked fresh. And obviously, we have the Zouk Festival, Zouk Out Festival. And we've always sort of tagged IMS onto something where we know there's going to be a lot of industry people there, which helps with regards to putting panels together and so on.
Right now in the IMS Asia Pacific hot seat, we have Jeremy Boone. Jeremy, thank you for joining us today.
Hi, good to see you.
You as well. Jeremy being a Zouk resident from day one, pretty much.
Zouk has always been like pushing dance music, and you know, honestly, we don't get much support from, you know, people around the region or the other side of things. So, and having IMS coming in, right, you actually bring the music industry people from around the world to congregate here and to see what the whole excitement has been for the past 23 years, which is a good thing. So in a way, it's just, if give people an opportunity to see the possibility of things that can happen in Singapore. It's a great place for something to grow, especially musically. Yeah.
Sat next to me now is the number one female DJ in Asia, here from Bangkok. It's Celeste Siam. Celeste, welcome to IMS Asia Pacific, and thanks for chatting to us here on DJ Sound.
Swadika, I'm very excited and be honored to join IMS panels and pre-party and after party. It's just fantastic and exciting to see IMS Ibiza come to Asia for the first time.
You played the pre-party last night with Pete Tong at Attica, and you're also playing the after party with Paul Oakenfold. What did you enjoy about playing the party last night?
Actually, it's my first time to play in Attica, and I love the place. And we have two songs, like different kind of music. People, there was night crowd, and I was excited to play for Pete Tong and Paul Oakenfold. I think it's one of the great party.
So you had a fun night, yeah?
Yeah, have a great night, and yeah, my voice is a bit loud. That's mean we've been through a good party.
Why'd you bring Steve Angello into the mix for, you know, a keynote one-on-one with you?
I've been trying many years to get him in the room, and he was meant to do LA this year, and last minute it couldn't happen. And so he's been a massive supporter of the IMS from the start. He knows all of the partners really well. He's outspoken. He's a real independent. He's a control freak, and he's got a lot to say. And he was in the region, so it all lined up. So that's why we wanted him. I thought he was a really compelling interview. I've done a lot of interviews already over the years with the IMS, but I thought it was one of the best. I thought he was really good.
Dr. Giyu, and he had some really funny and interesting things to say about music and medicine.
Basically, you know, putting it right out there, let's just, you know, call a spade, you know, drugs is an issue, you know, that there's a massive part of the culture, and yet, in this part of the world, if the drugs don't kill you, the authorities will for taking them. So how is that going to be a barrier to the development of in this marketplace?
Steve Angello, welcome to IMS.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I feel great.
Why do you think that they've asked you to be a part of IMS here in Singapore?
You know, we've been talking a little bit. They like that I have a different sense of what's going on as well, you know. A lot of people are artists, but I'm also a promoter, and I'm an owner of a record label, and I'm A&Ring, and I'm doing management and everything else. So they can go pretty wide, which I think they appreciate.
Would you agree then that Singapore was the right choice to host the first IMS Asia Pacific event?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's Singapore's a hub for a lot of things. You know, I think Singapore's a great city to do things in, and you know, the structural work that they've done here with the whole city is amazing, you know. So I think it was the right move.
East versus West, why do you think that they invited you to be on that panel?
I guess that with my recent single Lover's Eyes, they felt that there was a connection. I've been playing in Asia, in some parts of Asia, for some time, very regularly at WOOM in Japan and various festivals, and recently in India. I'm just about to explore some new areas on this trip, so I guess they felt it was a good fit.
KUVO officially launched 2 months ago. What has been the reception since then, since it launched at ADE?
Look, from my perspective, it's been fantastic, because there's a kind of a connection, a deliberate connection, because AFEM endorsed KUVO as technology to help our Get Played, Get Paid initiative. So that was, I think, a very sensible decision, because working together with a big brand, then you're able to create momentum, and everybody got talking about it very quickly. So I think it benefited AFM, I think it benefited KUVO.
Here I am now with Lincoln Cheng, who is the owner and founder of Zouk and Zouk Out Festival, and he was here today for a keynote interview with Paul Oakenfold. Lincoln, absolute pleasure to have you here with us on DJ Sounds. How are you?
Pleasure to be here. It's the first time IMS come to Asia. It's great to be part of it.
So when did the founders first approach you about doing something here in Singapore?
It was about 6 months ago. It was a pretty rush job, actually, to organize all this. Partly Zouk is always does the pioneering, be it music or lifestyle. We have always been ahead of the leading the trend anyway. And also the very important part of IMS is having Zouk Out right after it. I mean, Zouk Out was the main draw.
Paul Oakenfold, your relationship with him, he was one of the first globe-trotting DJs of his generation, let's say, and he spent a lot of time in Asia. So to have a one-on-one chat with him, did that feel quite right?
Yeah, I think he's a pioneering DJ that plays Asia also. He loves, instead of getting a bigger fee in developed cities, he'll come to China, he'll come to Vietnam to experiment with these markets.
How are you, Ben?
Great. I'm very relieved. It's all over.
I'll bet. It's been such a build-up, but wow, you guys pulled it off again.
Yeah, this was, I think, our shortest attempt. It was 2 months we announced this event. We really saw an opportunity. We're very passionate about growing IMS and passionate about growing the industry, and saw a great opportunity here to bring together people from all the different countries. I'll be honest with you, with LA and Ibiza, we're sharing our knowledge for people. This time I felt it was the other way around. As we were curating it, I was having to do phone calls with people to learn about the region or talk to people and understand what they're doing, trying to work out who are the real players. Zouk really helped us with some of that stuff. But everything today to me has been an education. Every panel I wanted to grab minutes of, seconds of, because everything is just valuable stuff that we want to learn. So I actually felt like a delegate today, which was quite nice. Mm. Yeah, I mean, just culturally, this place is beyond your imagination. It's I've only scratched the surface of here, of Japan and Singapore, and this day has just made me want to go out and explore all of those places, and who knows what we'll do with IMS next in this region. But I feel like somebody just said to me, this feels like year 5 of IMS somewhere. So that's quite a nice thing to say about our first attempt at being in Asia.
Thank you from Pioneer DJ, who's been another massive part of the summit and since it started. Hideki, it's quite noisy now, it's a party time, but I think Pioneer likes the party as well.
Yeah, Pioneer DJ loves the party, it's always in the middle of the scene. Yeah, we're really happy to be at the beginning of the IMS in Asia, and also be as a speaker inside.
So maybe you could tell us a little bit about the panel today. It was Get Played, Get Paid.
Yes, we originally planned for the KUVO to be kind of discover the music and discover the DJ, discover the club. But when we were talking with Ben and Richie, the KUVO can contribute to another way. So we started to talking with each other and how we can, kind of cooperate with other. And then we finally came up with some kind of great ideas. Just we having many inquiries regarding the KUVO boxes. So all around the world, we get people who wants to install the KUVO inside, and also we currently have about 160,000 DJs applied, and also many tracks being played inside KUVO. So we're really happy about the result.
And how many clubs is it installed in now?
It's 310, but it's increasing day by day. Yeah.
We've got Mim. Girls, it's been a great day. It's great to have you here in Singapore as part of the very first Asia Pacific IMS. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. It's spreading. It's now in Asia. We've seen it in Singapore. We've seen the scene just explode in general. And it's amazing to see the turn up here. You know, tonight's party was crazy. The seminars have been really well received. Loads of people, loads of questions.
What do you feel that you guys brought to today's discussion?
Well, you know, there was Damian, Lazarus and us, we were the artists on the panel, and we just spoke about our experiences, and our experiences have been that, you know, major Western
festivals
have
like now, Ultra,
have moved out to Asia. So it's just great to see it explode, and
it's a very relevant place here. Like, people want to grasp onto and submerge themselves in all of this music.